And 70 years ago today, one of the largest tragedies in the history of the smoke jumper firefighters happened just north of Helena. Recently, I hiked into Mann Gulch with the Forest Service to see the area that would be the final resting place for these brave men and learn the history of that fatal day along the Missouri River.
You can't mess with some of these elements when they're against you. I mean, you're in big trouble sometimes.
On August 5th, 1949, 15 smoke jumpers from Missoula were dropped into the Mann Gulch area of the Helena National Forest to fight a reported lightning spark fire. At first glance, it was an easy task for the skilled crew, but problems started immediately. First, the crew's gear was scattered all over the landscape. Their only radio was destroyed, cutting them off from the outside world. Once on the ground, as the crew began to gather their scattered equipment, Foreman Wagner Dodge went in search of any ground units already fighting the fire. But he found only one man, James Harrison. Adding Harrison to the crew, the men moved down gulch to attack the fire. But a wind shift caused previously unnoticed spot fires, trapping the crew between two fires on both sides of the gulch.
What's interesting about this one, though, is that wind not only changed direction and did a right turn, and came up that canyon, it came up the canyon when it was getting toward the end of the day, and it probably should have been going down the canyon.
With the fire roaring at what the Forest Service now estimates to be 30 miles per hour right at the smoke jumpers, they had to make a life or death decision, and they had to make it fast. Dodge ordered his men to drop their tools and head for the ridge, but with fire nipping at their heels on a steep slope like this one, it was a race that 13 of them wouldn't win. With flames devouring the landscape behind the men, Dodge did something that hadn't been taught to the jumpers before. He lit the unburnt grass around him on fire, burning the area to black and robbing the flames of fuel. Dodge then tried to get his men to join him, but in all the chaos of trying to outrun the inferno and not having any prior knowledge of Dodge's strategy, nobody listened and they all fled up the ridge. Alone in that patch of burnt earth, Dodge wet a handkerchief, put it over his mouth, and laid face down in the burnt out area as the main fire passed. Only Dodge and two other smoke jumpers, Robert Salih and Walter Rumsey, would survive. The Mann Gulch fire took the lives of 13 brave men. But from that tragedy came a change to the way wildland fires are fought and understood, with more attention being placed on wind, weather, and attack strategies to lessen the chances of any similar tragedies happening in the future. The DC and the DC-3 that carried the smoke jumper team to the Mann Gulch fire flew back over the site today to honor those firefighters who died.